university na convener for hostel sports and library 2014 Madurai Kamaraj university academic audit member of physical education 2014 Annamalai university committee additional member
please
university
to pesadinga
document committee member 2014 Annamalai University UPE Coordinator Faculty of Education 2015 and 16 Annamalai University IQSE Nodal Officer Faculty of Education 2016 and 17 Annamalai University Physical Education the means of ragging committee in the 2016-17 Annamalai University Counseling Member 2014-17 Annamalai University Tender Committee Member Canteen 2013 Annamalai University PhD Admission Faculty Education Instruction The Annamalai University Warden and Deputy Warden 7 years I am very happy sir dear participant and our college staff member I am once again I am very happy to introduce our today afternoon chief guest speaker my teacher my PhD guide my role model in the profession my trainer and my well-wisher thank you sir I am happy to given to opportunity I am thank you sir welcome once again he is going to deliver his the knowledge with the topic of fitness versus COVID-19 fantastic topic sir Another, I warm welcome, Mr. Sabari Ganesh, Tamil Nadu PEFI Chapter Secretary, and welcome to honor our invited guest. Please, Mr. Sabari Ganesh.
Hello, good afternoon, yes. Nadal. Yes. Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here in the Zoom platform for this wonderful international webinar. Today's session, we are expecting more things and we have to know and we have to feed the knowledge with us by the presentation of Dr. V. Gopinath, the Registrar, Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University, Chennai, Tamil Nadu. In my point of view, his knowledge is equal to library. In my vision, my knowledge, his knowledge is equal to library. And I got a lot of experience with Dr. V. Gopinath, the beloved Registrar of Tamil Nadu Sports University. And on behalf of Government Thirumagal Mills College and Tamil Nadu PEFI chapter, we heartily welcome you, sir, for this wonderful afternoon session with the topic of fitness versus COVID-19. In these pandemic days also, we just sent a request to Dr. V. Gopinath, sir, and suddenly, yeah, I will do for us and for our department. And thank you so much for accepting our request, sir, to presenting this wonderful session. Thank you, sir, and most welcome, sir. And I most welcome every participants from all over India. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sabari Ganesh, sir. I invite our special guest and speaker, Professor Dr. V. Gopinath, sir, head of the section, sir.
5 minutes, please.
5 minutes. Thank you, sir. Some inconvenient.
Gopi sir is coming. Please listen the section. Just 2 minutes. Start the section.
Yes, yes, sir. Please.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are audible. Yes, you are audible, yes, sir. Most welcome, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. audible and also visible, sir. Please.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, mic konja kitta vachu pesunga sir. Mic konja kitta vachu pesunga sir.
Acha acha. Okay. Very good evening to one and all those who are in the webinar. I would like to record my sincere thanks to the organizing team, the principal, GTM College of Gundiyadam, Dr. S. Kaveri Ammal, and Dr. P. Vasugi, the convener, Dr. M. Murali Krishna, the organizing secretary, and Mr. S. Sabari Ganesh, coordinator for the 2 days international webinar on essential of physical fitness and health wellness during COVID-19 pandemic, in association with the co-banner of Fit India and PEFI Tamil Nadu chapter. So I hope there is a lot many distractions in between before I start the program. Already I am delaying, I am running by a short of time. Now today's my discussion goes on fitness versus COVID-19. Yes, I used to give the crisp topping. This time also I'm making the same thing. Up to 4 months before, they are most of the South Asians are walk high and having a different opinion and different thought in their mind and lifestyle too. Moreover, we people are honestly and happily declaring that we are living 21st century, missionary world, and everything in the push button era, we are in the hands of everything in our hands. And we can say we are declaring also world of communication. We happily say that, proudly saying we are in world of communication. But the present scenario says we are in world of corona, because a small virus, which is unseen, which is nano-level, micron, very small level, but that affects the biggest, the most genius species in the earth, and you can say the globe. So by seeing all this thing, the humanities clashed together, and they have hand in glove with every country, across the country, across the world, across the continent. We are discussing how to overcome, how to win the battle against the COVID-19. The fight against the corona, if you ask a question on it, how to fight against the corona, the experts suggest and they have a strong belief that there are 4 aspects they are listing out. One is chemical, there's a pharmacological, vaccination or tablets, like the pharmacological part. Second one is diet, third one is exercise, and last is sleep. So all these 4 cluster together, join together, and make the people prevent themselves, or they can get fast, speedy recovery from the COVID-19, or they can prevention technique they are having. Then by having the 4 components, the chemical component, diet, exercise, and sleep, we belong to a family of sports science and physical, you can say physical education. What is our contribution? Because it's a public issue. So every scientist are trying to address the issue and to solve the problem at an early date or at an early time. But what is our part? So by thinking on this line, I have few ideas, and with my experience, and I have come across some literatures, and during my research and long back, one is in immunology, I conducted research in immunology too, very long back. So all these things give an idea that, moreover, Dr. Murali Krishna also called me regarding this topic. So I'm interested to join with you. Why the exercise is required? The people think that how the exercise can help fight against the corona. Yeah, the people believe, and the doctors and physicians and other people are saying that if you have the sound immune system, you can prevent your body, or you can prevent from corona or COVID system, pandemic condition. So how the exercise helps? It is an indirect method. So when you activate your muscles, the muscles are activating your cells, indirectly cells. So finally, the intracellular changes are taking place. So when the intracellular changes are taking place, the immune system is also changeable. And some literature is also supporting that. So when you increase the immune system, automatically the wellness will come into you because we are fighting together. So wellness coming together. What happens when you exercise? Exercise make a physical movement or a muscular movement. So when the physical movement or muscular movement takes place, the tissue is the particular set of tissue or a muscle is involving a set of movement, and that the deeper sense is for the cell and molecular changes. So when the molecular changes are taking place, there are all possible mRNA changes or hormonal changes or even immune system and so on. So why? That's why we are dependent, or we can say that we can also contribute to prevent ourselves even to overcome these corona by doing good exercises, because the sound mind is the sound body. There's a famous quotation is that. So now there is a different opinion about what is an exercise, what type of exercise can be performed while we are in the pandemic or in the lockdown situation. Everybody is addressing that I am not having pavilion, I'm not having ground, I'm not having fitness gym, all gyms are closed, all fitness. All fitness
center.
Fitness center are closed.
Please
mute your room.
Somebody has to mute. Some other center. Instead of that, you can design your exercise in your home itself. So what type of exercise can you perform? So if you have general classification on the basis of energy system, there are two types of energy system. We have aerobic energy system and anaerobic energy system. Is it audible, Murali?
Audible, no, sir. Audible. Basically.
Aerobic. Aerobic anaerobic energy system and anaerobic energy system we have. So when you go for anaerobic, it is short blast of energy, that is 120 seconds, not more than that. But when you go for aerobic energy system, it metabolizes glucose and it goes for fat also. So when the fat is burning, we have more energy conservation, more energy expenditure is there. Beyond that, we can have maintain our BMI level also. So now, is it possible to exercise regularly? That's another question arises in the midst of youth as well as the aged and child, because the people doesn't have the attitude towards the pavilion or towards doing activity regularly. Even we belong to physical education. When we are after training college, we are not following regularly. Hardly 3 days, twice a week or thrice a week we are doing. Just we are maintaining the fitness. Is it enough and is it possible? But exercise and stay in track for a long year is a mental training. I can say it's a mental game, actually. So honestly speaking, it is a mental game. If you have tough mind and if you have a constant attraction or a constant passion towards the exercise and your love your body, then you can do it. Otherwise, you can easily lose your mental game. So now, second thing I can say that you can treat your body as your enemy. Because when you are in pavilion, there is a without pain, there is no gain for you. So if you want to have your gain, you have to set that. So now the people are not ready to do that. But once if you go to the pavilion, you have to work. Your muscle has to stretch. The muscle has to involve some type of activities. So beyond all this thing, I would like to say that when you're interested to have the mental, ready to play mental game, and you treat your body as an enemy, especially in the part of exercise, doing the exercise, you have to adhere some principles. That is, you have to say no to smoke, alcohol, environmental risk, and overweight. Now, we are having, because we are in the British colony, the cycle, I am not mentioning everybody in society, but mostly the people are ready to listen rather than ready to take the issues. They have less leadership quality. So somebody has to come and they have to teach, they have to exhibit, they have to demo. Then only the people are following. Instead of that, you should have resolution now, self-care practice. So I have to care myself. If no one is there, who is going to be responsible for it? So you have to respond for your loose and bad, good and bad. So there are four components they are also saying for self-care practice: the sleep, hydration, exercise, and nutrition. So now we can roll out the nutrition because we are not much specialist in the nutrition side. There are so many people are interesting. What are the good nutrient material to increase, boost your immune system? But and malnutrition itself is a cause for your lacking of immune system or your immune system become weaker. So once if you have adhere these two, sleep, do good hydration, and exercise with a good nutrition, if you maintain this pandemic time or during lockdown time, your natural biorhythm should be maintained. But I am seeing in my family and some other friends' family and the friend circle, but the whole circadian, the biological rhythm of people might have been changed after this lockdown. Okay, I'm honestly saying March 24th, after 24th of March, the routine has been changed. There is no outing for them. There is no society-related activities. So they sit together in between the four walls and they are discussing themselves and they are keep on making the classes or chatting with their friends or they are in the online only most of time. So when sometimes they go for late to bed and very late in morning. So our biological rhythm is keep on changing. So your jet lag is keep on changing. So this is another bad siren we are having, that we are not maintaining our natural rhythm or biorhythm because we are following our solar system. So our solar system is going. The pandemic or COVID comes or not, our sun has come, sun has go. It is routine. But we changed. All fantas are working in par with this solar system. But we human always violating the solar system, going to late to the bed, not proper sleep or not having 8 hours sleep, all these things may affect our immune system. How to do exercise? Then again, there's another question that I said. So, okay, I'm ready to exercise. I'm prepared. Fine. What to do? How to do? How much I have to do? Then there are a lot of questions again and again just arising. So now, during this situation, your regular exercise, because you have enough time with you, regular exercise, moderate intensity from your heart rate, some 55% to 70% is enough. You are not going to be competed as well. You are maintaining your fitness and you have to address your support to your immune system to work effectively. For that only you are working now. So 55% to 70% intensity is more than sufficient. It should be aerobic in nature. Some studies are saying that the duration is 30 to 60 minutes is more than sufficient to turn over immune system, turn over all muscular system and cellular modification. And some studies are saying that 150 minutes per week. That's a tonnage of workout they are saying. 150 minutes of aerobic exercise per week is also good. But all these things are saying a moderate level of exercise is always advisable for a good and healthy body. You can say it's a healthy body and a healthy organ. But we never follow, but we people are more ambitious. What we think, instead of 40 to 50, 30 to 50, 60 minutes, why don't you go for some more time? So we are stretching our time with 55 minutes, 60 minutes, 70 minutes, 80 minutes. And we are increasing intensity also. So if you are 75 minutes of both, if you are 75 minutes of both, performed by individual, it leads to negative effect to your immune system. Some literatures and some research findings are speaking in immunology that they increase cortisol and affect your immune system. So cortisol is increasing if a duration is increasing. So now what most of the time the people are advising to refresh your body, to refresh your mind, then and there. The 20 minutes workout is more than sufficient. It's a short break. That's a short work break, they are saying. The 20 minutes is more than sufficient to regenerate your mind and body, to come back to normal and you can perform your routine activity. Just a cup of tea. Drink a cup of tea, it may motivate you, it may induce your system for 20 minutes or half an hour, sometimes it goes to 1 hour, a good coffee can go for 1 hour, it is a narcotic, it enhances your performance by increasing your nervous system. Same like that, when physical activity is involved, the blood circulation is activated, some enzyme activation may take place. So there is called acute effect. So the acute effect exercise is always having a positive side. So now we'll see that what are the benefits when you perform the exercise or fitness program during the COVID, during the pandemic condition. when you perform, when you involve any type of physical exercise, automatically the circulation system is activated. That's the base, first and foremost. All, apart from the, along with this, a parallel system is a rail. So circulation, respiration, parallel activating. So when these system is two activating, then it is interlinking with the other system, or the all nine systems, remaining nine systems. So when circulation, respiration is activated, what happened? It works with this cellular. Already I told you, it is a microlet goes. So it works in the cellular components. So when it works in the molecular changes are taking place, the strength enough antibodies taking part in it. So immune cell function is increased. So let us discuss what are immune cells. We are having in due course. So immune cell function is increasing. That's why I'm telling now, immune cell function is increasing. So once if you have the physical activity, then your energy level is shoot up. You don't feel a drowsiness or a tiredness. Because somebody says that it is a myth in the people that if you go pavilion, if you go workout for in the sports ground or in the participant sports, you may lose your energy. It's not like that. The excess energy you are losing, you are refreshing your body, you are refreshing your mind, you are refreshing your circulatory system, and automatically your energy level is always high for the next activity or for subsequent participation. But digestion is increasing. The positive mind has come to you, because when you feel you are comfortable, you are capable of doing, there is no question of dependence. You not depend someone else, or you not ask someone else for helping you for your job or for your activity. So when you fit, your positive mind come to you, then caloric bursting of calories is more for you, increased. Exercise increases calorie burning, because without that we can't do any physical movement. And this new studies are speaking now, it increased the bone more density. That's a beautiful thing. I would like to pass a message. That's why the fight, I put a word fight. Fitness with the COVID-19. It's a fight between the human races as well as the natural resource, nature. So now we are, both are natural, but we are fighting. Bone marrows are increasing. When bone marrows are increasing, muscle mass is parallelly increases. Now, when bone mass increases, muscle mass is increasing, and you have good circulation system, respiratory system, your cellular modification is taking place, and our molecular changes are taking place in cell in the fundamental level, then obviously brain health and function is quite good, because your mind has to instruct. Your brain has to instruct your attitude, your behavior, your performance, everything you have to say. So when the mind says, your system obliges. So apart from this, if you see the circulatory system, the hemoglobin level, they say ideally 13 to 14 for adult, and 12 to 14 is for adult girl, adult woman. But an untrained, with a World Health Organization speaking, untrained people are having 1.5 grams of grams per kilogram. But when trained athlete, just can't imagine 15.7 grams per kilogram per kilo. So you see that's a 40% of increase in the HB. If you see the function of hemoglobin, now the problem of COVID is respiratory tract infection, or respiratory problem is more now. So why we need a respiration to transport the gases to the needed places, or they for make a living cells. So when you want to transport the gas, either oxygen to from remove carbon dioxide from there after the metabolism, the nitrate, or the waste product from the cellular from cell. So this blood has to make it. When blood circulation is good, quite good, and when hemoglobin is rich in your body, 40%, just imagine 40% increase. So hemoglobin alone having a capacity to attract the oxygen from our system. So it attracts more oxygen and supplies the oxygen to the working tissue and working muscles, so that definitely in the blood, if you analyze, partial pressure of oxygen increases. When partial pressure of oxygen increases, the most of problem comes down automatically. So when you perform some type of aerobic exercise regularly on bloodular changes, that make a molecule, that makes a cellular changes, and partial pressure of oxygen also increases, at last it increase the quality of life, as well as the body is in a fine thin condition. Second thing, the bone marrow, I already spoke to you, bone marrow. When the bone marrow is increases, it increases lymphocyte, WBC. It indirectly is a WBC. So when WBC numbers are increased, subcomponents are granulocytes are there, subcomponents are there. You have T cells, B cells, and NK natural killers are there. So when you exercise in 2014 and 15, there are so many studies are coming. for addressing that. Before also, there are some studies are coming when there is a AIDS complication is a very pandemic and such a very vast spreading in the in society. And some research in the recent past is also addressing that when you exercise moderately with aerobic quality, with aerobic exercise moderately, with 20 to 40 minutes in a day, that tone and that make the activity of NK cell or you're turning the NK cell to work faster than T cells and than B cells. So the natural killers are ready to work, ready to support our system. In parallel, vice versa, parallelly, there are some reduction, good reduction we are having when you execute your result. I mean, when executing your exercise. Certain tumor growth can be stopped or can be minimized, can be eradicated. Tumor growth, a risk of atherosclerosis, the heart blocking. There's excess fat coated inside the heart chambers, atherosclerosis, and ratio of HDL-LDL ratio, osteoarthritis complication, low back pain, upper respiratory tract infection, all these things are comes down. How? Because now the COVID is directly related with the respiratory tract. So when the respiratory tract is ready to respond and ready to fight and able to inhale more oxygen, more air, definitely you can supply or you can able to sustain with the COVID also. So now we see that then psychological part, most of time when disease comes, we are prone. We feel we are helpless, we are unheard, and we are scared about all these things. But the physical exercise gives the confidence to you and it eradicates your depression or minimizes your depression level because you are engaging, you are strong enough, you are active. So nothing, even the symptoms you have, since you are active, you need not worry about all these things. So the anxiety level comes down, stress comes down. Beyond all these things, when the stress comes down, the stress hormone activity is also reduced. Because when stress hormones are bursted, the neurons are broken, neurons are burst inside the brain with a very, very numerous number. Even one anger is enough, one second is enough, emotional imbalance is enough to have so much a burst in your brain. But see, cardiovascular disease risk factor also comes down because you have good health, you have good organs, you have very cordial organs with work, with a good understanding with the other supportive organs. Then new injuries are there. Inflammation is comes down very, very small because the lymphocytes are immediately addressing the problem. And in neutral site, it is not proven so far, but it is observed, it is recorded with most of the population. It is a psychological buffer. So obviously you can see if any boy or girl going for fitness center for a couple of days or for one week, couple of weeks, after that, if you see them, they gait, walking mechanism, the sitting style, and you can even talking mannerism, everything, because the physical fitness, the muscle mass will give the confidence to them. So that itself says that it's a psychological buffering. They have come out from the group. They're ready to take the opportunities. They can develop the leadership quality. Most of the successes are comes out with the psychological buffering only. So these few studies are saying that, cyber studies are saying that have psychological buffer. Then it's the healthy lifestyle. Once if you violate, if you quit smoking, alcohol, environmental hazards, and overweight, obviously, are quite naturally, you can have a good healthy lifestyle because alternatively you can plan when to sleep, how to eat, how much to eat, when to eat. Everything is scheduled for you. Because your body is preparing a particular schedule for you. According to the schedule, you are proceeding that. And your core temperature is maintained constantly. Because they are saying increasing the core temperature. But the exercise always maintains the core thermoregulation. So it's quite good for the person those who are exercising. Because when you exercise, the temperature goes high. The core temperature goes high. But after some time, it immediately comes down. It falls down very faster. So the thermoregulatory system is work very effectively and hydroregulation also works very effectively. A good emotional and mental health can taking place. There are recent findings saying that the behavioral measures are changing. After even this COVID period, the behavior change. A person involving yogic practices, person involving physical exercises, a person involving some sort of physical activity have some positive attitude towards work of COVID system. short studies are coming, survey studies are speaking on that. Some surveys are saying this. So irrespective of gender, both youth and old adults are having positive benefits while they are involved in the exercise. Again, as I already told you, there are so many problems. Thus, problem in the sense we are ambition, we are more ambitious, ambitious, and we are trying to do everything within short time. So with that, we have over exercising or over training, overreaching. They are saying training is overreaching or overtraining or over exercises. So in technical, there is hyper exercise syndrome. Then the hyper exercise syndrome is another bad sign, because exercise is good for health, but anything beyond the normal is poison to us. That leads to negative effect to our body. So what has happened when we exercise more? Well, that is also be discussed in this situation. Because we have good time. If you keep on doing exercises, definitely one fine time, you may have a less, the immune system will be affected. May not cope up with your requirement, may cope up with your demand. So upper respiratory tract infection is quite common when you exercise more, because more than 30 minutes or 40 minutes, more than 70% of Indians, if you perform, definitely you have a problem with upper respiratory tract infection. Some studies in Olympic athletes and some studies in now that elite athletes are speaking that after participating in the high level competition, especially long distance runner, they are more prone to upper respiratory tract infection or some cough, some cold, something like that, they are affecting. Apart from that, when you have the upper respiratory tract infection, then all possibilities are there.
Not audible, sir.
Please wait, please mute some network issue, please mute.
Voice is not clear.
Sir, kindly wait. Some network issues are there. Kindly wait, sir, please.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. At the same time, kindly mute yourself.
Please kindly mute.
Okay, sir.
Hello? Yes, hello? Sir. Is audible now?
Yes, sir. Okay. Audible now, sir. Audible.
It's okay, sir. Audible, okay, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So the overtraining or over-exercise is one of the cause for diminishing your immune system. The upper respiratory infection, I already discussed, the airborne diseases. The oxidative stress damage is coming down. And burst of oxygen is more when you are performing anaerobic type of activity. And reduce the antigen and reduce the immunoglobulin production in your body. So when you increase the physiological and psychological environmental stress because of overtraining, the physiological stress is there, psychological stress is there, and environmental stress is also there. Then finally, we can say that the circulation stress hormone is also increasing. But now the present scenario. Hello, somebody is unmuted.
Sir, sorry for the disturbance. Dear participants, kindly mute your mic, please. Dear participants, kindly mute yourself, please. Then, sir, kindly proceed. Now,
okay, thank you. Now the present condition.
Sir, yourself unmute, sir, please. It's a common. Thank you, sir.
Dr. Murli, sir, kindly mute Mr. Robinson. Kindly go through the participant list. He is making the disturbance.
Hello. Somebody is working now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Everything is okay, sir.
Thank you. The education system is now totally changing. So far we have the student-friendly system. We have students are coming to the school and we are teaching them. As an academician, as a physical educationist, we should plan something different because the online classes are stood up for all the classes, right from second standard, first standard onwards. All classes are stood up, even the college's program also stood up. So, most of time, minimum of 2 hours, each child has to have the mobile. Or that Zoom app, or the Google Meet. So now we see the moment is arrested. In school, after every 45 minutes, child used to climb, child used to move, child used to dodge, child used to jump, leap, all type of physical activities are there. But 2 hours continuous Zoom class, 2 hours continuous Google Meet, a child sits just like a statue. And there are some comments is also there. Because the parents are sitting, they are unmuting there like that. Now also we are facing the same thing. However, it is a fun. We should enjoy that also. But this, apart from this, they are sitting in front of social media also. Either YouTube, WhatsApp, or some other social media they are involving. And net service they are using. So in a total, approximately, when you are in lockdown period, an individual or a child involving or is engaging themselves minimum 6 to 8 hours in a day. That is 1/3 of a day. Will go either in front of TV, in front of computer, in front of mobile, smartphones, or in front of something like that in the electronic devices. This is also something acceptable. So unfortunate, after going to bed, I'm including myself now. After going to bed, most of us having a habituation to see the WhatsApp, to see the mails, and to see everything in two box, there only we are seeing. But we don't know that when this light penetrate our eyes, it took minimum 2 to 2.5 hours to reduce your secretion, brain secretion, to go for a sleep state. But we, without knowing that, just simply you switch off. We start, physical body starts sleeping, but your thoughts, everything goes higher and higher. That's why most of the youth nowadays having a dreams, whether wanted or unwanted dream, they shout during their sleep, they murmur during their sleep, all disturbed sleeps are there. So it is better, have a policy everywhere that before going to the bed, you finish your WhatsApp work and finish your tube work, and at least 1 hour before to the bed. That is somewhat advisable. Somewhat, it is my suggestion in this good forum. Now, when you go for academic side, it is a cognitive learning and motor learning. It's a combination. So education is trying to go for cognitive learning. It is a brain development of brain functioning and so on and so forth. The physical educationists are working towards the motor quality, body, muscles and other things, organs and other things. So when these two professions are goes in hand in glove, then only the whole system or their child is builded properly. So when a child want to have the build properly, definitely the cognition as well as the motor learning should go with a good proportionation of development. Now, what we are seeing, most of the time webinars are there, or most of the time the Zoom classes are based only for subject teachers. What about the physical education? What about sports? Other things we are not doing. Every week we have 2 hours of practical there, or 2 hours of classes there. Can we exercise something related to that? Can we prepare ourselves? We can say that we have no pavilion. We have no ground. So we are saying something compromising ourselves. Instead of that, plan what is available in each kit, house of each house. Any staircase is there, hall is there, stool, small stool is there, even kitchen table is there, dining table is there. You can make a chair, dining chair is there. You make use of that. A skipping rope is there, a window is there. So many devices, a wall is there. Without wall, no house is there. Make a wall as your partner. Go for some push and pull type of exercises. Static contraction, isometric you can do. Isotonic, isometric can go, nothing harm. Because you are going with less intensity only. So do some physical activity. So when you perform physical activity, you can have so many benefits as I told before. Now when you go for exercise, improves or assess your cognitive process, or cognitive development is more. Education is also supporting now. Before there is the idea that if a boy is playing, if a boy is going to pavilion, or if a boy is involved in sporting activity, he is not having knowledge in academics. He is graded, uneducated, or you can say he is less educated. He is not capable, he is not intelligent boy. Like this they are saying, it is not so. So recent studies are supports. The boy who involves sports or physical activity can improve the brain quality, the function of brain. There's a quality of brain function is increases. How it increases? First part, they are saying it's memory is increasing. How the memory is increasing? You can ask the question. So there are some internal changes that are taking place in the brain. Let us discuss that also nearby after a few minutes. So the brain has some alteration, brain has some changes. So the changes accommodate some new information. The folds are increases. The neurons are increasing in number. So all these things join together, and finally the brain efficiency is improved because you are performing a physical exercise. Because circulation is increasing, obviously blood shooting towards your hemispheres everywhere is more. Now, the beautiful thing of exercising, because every family there is a senior citizen. Age of 65, 70, 75, something 80, some blessed or 80 plus is also there. If you ask the grandchildren, the grandfather and grandma is keep on, the aunt or keep on saying the same story repeated 10 times, 15 times, 5 times, keep on saying. Why it is happening for them? Is the need for them? Whether they wanted they're doing? Not so. It is having a, they're having brain atrophy. They're having a brain atrophy. So when they are exercising, they are maintaining the brain activity, rhythm of brain, then brain atrophy, the age-related brain atrophy can be minimized, or sometimes we can not even notice that. That's a good thing. So it is better the senior citizen of each family should give an opportunity to go for a walk, some physical jerk. What are the possible for them? Even if you have a stick with them, you can walk, play with the kids, permit them, nothing harm. Or let them come for the dine from the bed to the dining room, and let them go back, and evening go ask them to go for a small walk in the either garden or a terrace, somewhere else, do some physical activity. So one fine time, they will be accommodated for this, they acclimatize for it, and finally, they're beneficial. Otherwise, the brain atrophy is reaching them or may conquer them at an early, and everybody is put into problem because of this. Brain tissue loss is reduced, and it protects depletion and degeneration of brain. So when you react, because if you see the scientist theories are there, everybody knows the Darwin theory, man drawn from monkey. Everybody knows that. the parallel, the contemporary scientists also say that, they say his name is Lamarck. He says that use and disuse theory. So when you keep on using an object or a particular part that is more active, it increases size or its quality. Suppose if you just to compare your hands or right and left hand together, which hand you are dominant, that hand is more circumference, more strength is more there, it perform better than your non-dominant hand. Like the, these give an example that flying birds are coming from flightless birds are coming from flying birds, ostrich. Bird has to fly. So, but the ostrich couldn't be able to fly. It run because for a long time, it doesn't have any enemy for it. So it lays the egg, it hatches the egg, it took the food, it grows the size and unable to fly. So diseases are there. Even if a fracture is there, when you make a plaster of Paris for 21 days or 45 days, after you remove that, you see that the hands are very thin in nature. You lose strength, even couldn't be able to make a movement because this is only for 45 days. So when the senior citizens are not using the organs, not using the extremity properly, definitely it is a burden not only for them, for society also. So it is a responsibility of every members of the family to engage the senior citizen in the right way or by as that like. But physical exercise is advisable. But wishes are also there, you should admit them. And see that cerebral study says that there is an increased anatomical quality, cellular, molecular, and functional aspects of brain, the exercise. The central nervous system and reflex mechanisms also turned and very that response is very faster than the untrained or than the normal people. The exercise people having these type of advantages. So now we go the next part of brain, very specific, because why I'm going brain now, where education, where cognition, where in the cognition side. So when you want to increase your cognitive quality or when you want to increase your brain capability, definitely you have to make something. So brain neuron health is most important. The number and health of neuron is more important because it only communicate or transmit the messages and store the information just like a cable in our electrical electrification. So when the strong wire is there, strong filaments are there, it gives the good conditions. Otherwise, the fluctuation of current will be there, quite obvious. Same way, if you have good neuron health, definitely we have a good brain and good functional brain we will be having. We need a functional brain. Then the brain derived neurotrophic factor, a new component, new theorem is established and a new idea has emerged now in the midst of some studies. And they say that they are saying BDNF, brain derived neurotrophic factor. So when these factors are increased due to exercise, they found out the exercise increases BDNF, which is present in the cortex and the hippocampus area of a brain. So cortex and hippocampus area of a brain is most responsible working for memory and storing everything. It's your hard disk, almost your hard disk. Everything is recorded there. So when you record everything, definitely your learning attitude and memory part is very effective, very identical. So previous they are saying that this is a genetical factor. You can mute a genetical factor, you can have some exercise program, you can able to train over a genetic mRNA character, and through which you can even have some modification or have some alteration, some adaptation in your body as well as in your organs, in the brain and everywhere. Studies are coming out now. It's not my word. Studies are coming out in such a way. Now, ever famous for home quarantine, what to do? Family, it is a good time for you to do family exercise. Join together, no need to, because everybody is in the same house. You know, you are not coming out anywhere. You have well-protected part, you have well-protected lives you are having. So better go with, put a good music, whatever music you want. Make a dance, make a move. Need not be a dance like a Prabhudeva, dance like some Sarugasana like that. Just make a movement. Any physical movement is a dance. You see the traditional dancers of ancient people, the man from hills. He dances, he enjoys the dance. He dance, drink, dine, he enjoy everything. He has a healthy life also, but we are not having dance. So dance with the family. That is enough. So remove all the furniture in your hall, make the TV, put the video there, some good video, or some audio cassette, audio in the TV or in your mobile phone, make a physical jerk along with the family. So it's a family time. You can enjoy. Once you've started enjoying your family time, you never feel you are away from family. You are always allowed to be with your family only. So it is one of the important messages. So the home quarantine, not only the working class people, the child is also, the school going people are also there. The elders are also there. So it is a right time to motivate a family physical education program. I humbly request the PEFI as well as the any organizer from some other NGO sectors may promote some family exercise or family fitness protocol YouTube, and that can be relate to the all the food doors of families, and they can see and they can enjoy the day one, day two, day three, like that, simple to compound to complex type of some program can be. We, yoga department, they are doing. Then we are not doing. We say there is no pavilion. Instead of saying no pavilion, you can do with the home exercises, some terrace exercises, some staircase exercises, some skipping exercises, some own body exercise, some partner type of exercise. Even your husband or wife can have a pull and push. It's a partner exercise. Nothing harm. If both child is there, both child fight each other, it is a physical exercise. Allow them, but it's not bad. It should not be a harm one. Fight a healthy fight. Just you see the animal. Every morning, a dog or a cat or a lion, it has a family. The small young one is to fight with each other, but there's no harm. There is no injury for them. They fight, they roll, they push, they pull, they shout. They do all stupid things, but it is exercise for them. In a family, they go together. So when you started to push and pull your muscles, definitely your health condition will shoot higher. The children, adolescent, adult, aged, golden era has undergo some sort of physical activity or exercise. So any exercise, as I told you, any exercise, it is not necessary to go for walking alone or walk should be done. Instead of that, you execute some exercise, any physical, climbing on the stair. Gardening is good exercise. Washing your clothes, instead of switch off a washing machine, wash your clothes. It's a good exercise, 1 hour good exercise you have every week. And cleaning your home, window cleaning your windows. So all these things are good exercises only. There is no shame of saying that I'm cleaning my house. It is your home, your hygiene, your health is in the hands of you. I think harm, you can do all these things. And I can see that there is one famous quote that immunologic clock run out from your body. If immunologic clock run out from your body, immunology, I say T cell, B cell, or WBC number, all immune system, which is the soldiers of our body, which fight against the foreign obstacles or foreign objects, which enters, penetrate your body, or blood, or your muscles, or cell, wherever it comes, through a lymphatic system, or through the body, other mechanism, you go and fight. For your immunologic clock runs out, it stops. Then what happened? You are dead. So people are saying chemical, it is temporary measures. But when your body itself prepare a medicine, you develop immune system through your muscles, through your cellular changes, through your molecular changes, definitely it will withstand for a long time, and it will fight again and again whenever the foreign body come into you. And let have one small proverb here. It's a very famous one. I used to repeatedly say that because I love this. With my comfortable, I change that. Prevention is better than cure. It's a known quotation, a known notation. Everybody is saying prevention is better than cure. But the present scenario, the government is speaking, every country is speaking, World Health Organization is speaking, UNESCO is speaking. Prevention is better than cure is outdated. Precaution is better than prevention. So now the precaution steps are most essential. So towards that, the government is preparing, government is working hard, and the country is supporting, every government is working hard, every policy is making towards that. And across the country, across the continent, people are transferring knowledge, doctors are having consultancy, and the biochemists are working together, and the protection people are working, our safeguards are doing with us. And we also joined our hand with the society, with the government, and with other sector. And as I told you that previously, that self-care protection is protective mechanism is most effective mechanism. And if you are not loves you, then who will be there? So you are the cause, whatever you have been now. There's another saying is also there. So with these few words, I would like to say thanks to the GTM College, principal and organizing committee members, PEFI in PEFI India and PEFI Tamil Nadu chapter, and Fit India sponsors, as Fit India participants, and all the participants, those who are listening to me, those who are watching the discussion so far, and the finally I pray the Almighty, I have trust on it. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy, be happy, and support the nation to fight against the corona, COVID-19. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable time spent for the very good information, sir.
Thank you.
The audience, so many audience silent, observe.
Okay.
Sir, one more question.
Tell me.
Sports students in the college and school level. No activity. Some affected emotionally and the stress totally.
Okay.
So how to release the stress and the emotion?
The stress can be released through your physical exercise only, no other go. Because they are youth, surplus energy is there. Energy should be spent out. When the energy is not spent out, definitely the pressure will be there. The muscle is to tighten. They fight with each other. Or some stress will the burst. They put the pressure on the family or some other elders or younger. To overcome all these things, it is better as well go for some dance, some walk, some physical exercise. Even you go for some burpee exercise in your home. It's enough. Some static exercise in your house, some partner exercises, skipping is available. So like that you can do. Because mass exercise is prohibited, banned now. You're not able to go mass exercise. It's better 20 minutes of exercise in morning, 20 minutes of evening, or late early evening, and 20 minutes of late evening, 1 hour per day, 3 sets. 3 bouts of exercise is good. And not only it reduces stress, and it also helps him to grow high because the bone mass are increasing. The growth spur for them, school boys, they're adolescent. Adolescent need some type of exercise, stretching exercise, muscle stretching. So instead of that, if you sit together and if you fold your legs and fold your hands and keep on watching the tube for your webinar classes or Zoom meet, and finally, as I told you, the disuse theory will exist for you. It is better every 1 hour, go fast, stretch your muscles. At least stretch from a chair, you can stretch. Sit up from a chair and do some physical exercise, jerk in the part itself. That is good.
Of course, sir. This year,
yes.
AIU tournament, if you possible, organizing.
The first thing, last year program is so far not completed. Examination is not over so far. Yes. The UGC given guidance only September, before September last week, we have to finalize it. Later only the UGC, Asia Indian University have the committee and they have to form and whether to conduct the and what are the feasibilities of them. So many things are there, I am not authority to say. However, we pray for the four best, the expert, the AIU meet will come, and Kerala should come. The new experience, all the youth. Good experience too.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
again,
brother, anything else?
Please, please, sir.
Yes, I am waiting.
The Tamil Nadu Physical Education Foundation India, the president, Sambath sir here. I am watching.
Okay. Sambath.
Professor, vanakkam.
Vanakkam.
Vanakkam. And on behalf of FFI, again, we welcome you. And we really thank from the bottom of the heart. Tamil Nadu vandu udrakalvi vandu megaperiya sakthi.
Yes.
அந்த சக்தி வந்து தமிழ்நாடு ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் யூனிவர்சிட்டி கவர்மெண்ட் கீழ வந்து எல்லா அதற்கு வந்து பெஃபி ஒரு முன்னொரு என்ன சொல்லணும் ஒரு பிராண்டா முன்னால நிக்குது எல்லாத்தையும் ஒருங்கிணைக்கணும் அப்படின்ட்டு நாம வந்து மிகப்பெரிய ஒரு என்ன சொல்லணும்னா மெடிக்கல் அசோசியேஷன் இந்தியன் மெடிக்கல் அசோசியேஷன் மாதிரி பிசிக்கல் எஜுகேஷன் அசோசியேஷன் தேவைப்படுது ஃபாரம் தேவைப்படுது
Please communicate in English.
Hello.
Still speaking English.
Sorry. Okay, sorry.
Sabka Sat. Sabka Viswas.
Sir, please.
Yes, please, I am talking
in English, yeah, sir. Yeah. We can't understand what you are saying in Tamil.
That is a thing. I pray for you, Sabka Viswas, Sabka Sat. Okay? And on behalf of Tamil Nadu PEFI, we really welcome everyone, particularly today's guest and Professor Gopinath sir, my good friend. And it is team PEFI Tamil Nadu, Sabari Ganesh, and Kudiyatham Physical Director, Sir Go.
Yes, we are in the across the world now. Yes.
Yeah. Both. And the team has been running for 1 year, and we are looking for a good program like 1.0 PEFI Tamil Nadu. This is an eye-opener. And I really, we recall the days. I'm sure that Tamil Nadu will be one of the modest and one of the finest PEFI chapter in the country. And we go into a lot of things, sir. We want your bless and cooperation, Tamil Nadu Sports University, and especially from Gopinath Professor. We are expecting from your end, sir. That's what we can learn. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir, I'm online. Hello, sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
It's a great experience. It's a great pleasure to listen to your lecture, sir. And definitely your wordings and your key points are very useful. One and all the participants all over from India, sir. So definitely we will follow your key points, and definitely we fight against COVID-19 and we prevent ourselves with the cautions derived from you, sir. And bottom of the heart and behalf of Tamil Nadu's Physical Education Foundation of India, Tamil Nadu chapter, I heartily thank you on behalf of everybody, sir. You, sir, could you please unmute your mic, sir, please?
Thank you, Mr. Sabari Ganesh.
Most welcome, sir. Most welcome.
Thank you, sir. Any clarified from the RDN side? Any question in the audience state? One or two questions.
Sir, speak loudly, sir.
Dr. Murli, sir, kindly speak a little bit louder.
Yes. Okay.
Your voice getting too low, sir. That's why.
Yes. Okay, sir. Thank you for the section. The vote of thanks, and happy to invite the convener of the program, Dr. Vasuki, ma'am. Vasuki, ma'am.
Sir, I'm on mute. Good evening, everybody. On behalf of the Department of Physical Education, GTM College, as the Physical Education Committee member and convener of this international webinar, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to our resource persons of today, Dr. Gopinath, Registrar of Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University, Chennai, for this session, and Professor R. Thirumalai Sami, former first Vice Chancellor of Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University, Chennai, for their deliberations today. With regard to the afternoon session, I was extremely happy to know that Sir's deliberations on health issues and theories relating to health, learning and memory that affects the human health system, and the vital importance of dance was quite interesting and fascinating to make note of. Sir, your noteworthy statement that precaution is better than prevention has to be benchmarked today in this pandemic session. So on behalf of the GTM College and the Physical Education Department, I once again thank you for your deliberations, your precious time that you spent with us. And we also promise that we will do some positive attitude and positive work towards sports and the enhancing of sport activities in our campus. So with this, I would like to thank the participants, the organizers, the co-organizers, and the collaborators, especially Dr. Murali Krishna. Thank you, one and all.
Ma'am, please confirm the resource person name.
Resource person, afternoon, it was Dr. Gopinath, Registrar, Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University, Chennai, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, any feedback from?
Excuse me, ma'am. Any feedback form is there for attendance?
Yes, yes. That yes, will be sent. That will be sent to you through the chat.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. It's my duty.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're most welcome, everyone. And thank you, ma'am. For the tomorrow
thank
session.
You, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I'll waiting for tomorrow session.
Thank you, the all member of TNP Tamil Nadu Sports University. Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, sir.
Thank you for the wonderful organization. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, one and all. See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow timing.
Tomorrow time. I think it will come.
11 a.m.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am. It was a very good experience.
Hello.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, ma'am.
Welcome.
Wonderful session to all.
Thank you.
Okay.
Ma'am, what's your name to? Ma'am, what's your name, please? Hello, ma'am.